I think when we think about critical infrastructure, most people think of that as the lights, the airlines, the water. But I always think of a quote from William Gibson. How many people know who William Gibson is? He's a fantastic author. And he says, the future's already here. It's just not widely distributed yet. We live in a time where computers control things about our lives we're not even familiar with any longer. That Dr. Matiana's comment about smartphones, beneath simplicity of an iPhone is elegant complexity. The things that run that device and what it's possible, what's capable doing. Think about a smartphone now being used in a distributed denial of service attack against a banking institution. Or think about this, a simple USB stick taking down millions of dollars worth of nuclear equipment. That's the world we live in today. The future is already here, it's just not widely distributed yet. When we think about cybersecurity, this is also a very interesting problem for us because today it's a very broad and somewhat undefined term and is a bit overloaded. For some people, it's still about protecting their PC from malware. Maybe they're afraid of loss of their credit card or their personal information. But for others in the room, it's about protecting a nation and how to do that. And that's an incredibly complex problem. For us at GE, we're makers of critical infrastructure across all domains. We believe that it's about how we design, build, and support that infrastructure to protect it from cyber-related consequences. So now it's no longer about a system going offline, but it's about a system being exploited to cause damage or harm. To us, that directly relates to things we think about that are normal in the safety realm. That normal in reliability of devices or improve the quality of those devices. It's very critical to us that we think about that with cyber because cyber is not something you can see and touch, but it's very, very real today. And when you think about us as a company, and many of the people in the room here are probably part of critical infrastructure domains today, we think about all 18 domains as they're defined by our government, where we play, whether that's dams, whether that's power distribution, hospitals, emergency systems, all of those are vulnerable to cyber attack today. But why do we need to do it now? Well, we're seeing an increasing pace at which industrial control services, the mechanical elements that control valves, that control the flow of water or oil, are being digitized and connected to networks. And when we do that, when we connect them to standard networks, they are on a collision course with business networks. And those of you in the room who have worked in the cyber industry for a long time know that these collision courses and the rise of the concept of an Internet of Things creates a risk that these devices are now increasingly exposed to malware and bad kinds of behavior that have been in existence on the public Internet for more than 20 years. We also know that market forces are driving these behaviors. An increasing demand for mobility, to be mobile on your smartphone and being able to access your bank account today, but tomorrow to be able to control industrial infrastructure from your smartphone or from your iPad. We know that remote management is a direct result of what we're seeing in the way that businesses think about reducing cost. That if they can reach these systems like a substation remotely, they don't need to send somebody out in a truck. Now, every time we do that, that creates more opportunity for exploit. Every time we wirelessly enable an interface, that makes it more vulnerable. And these are the things that we have to think about. We also are looking at increasing legislation and regulatory pressure across the international community. These are things we have to consider as we build now. They're not something that we can do as an afterthought. The other thing we're very cognizant of, and I know this is not new to Israel, is the increasingly sophisticated malware that is targeting critical infrastructure. We know that this is, again, the concept of the future already being here today, but most people are simply just not aware. Lastly, the most devastating consequences exist when we talk about cyber to physical consequence in the critical infrastructure domains. This isn't about your PC crashing or you losing a credit card. This is about someone being harmed from medical equipment that's been tampered with. This is about aircraft going offline or maybe potentially being damaged. This is about power distribution networks going dark in the middle of winter. These are the kinds of things that are now possible from the cyber domain into the physical realm. And this is a little bit about what GE is doing today. And this is more about our attempt to be better at as a critical infrastructure provider to address cyber to physical consequence in the products that we make. And as a result, we've started new cybersecurity efforts here in Israel in cooperation with the talent that's in this environment and in this country to help us better defend and build safer products from cyber-related consequences. And it also applies to what we're doing around research with our partnerships and our business development, how we're designing our software, and where we're seeking the talent. So I know I have about 1 minute left, and I'm done early.